the stuff is landing or crashing around the world, and unexpected countries have had this happen. Like, what the hell just crashed in northern Italy? That is not ours, but let's look at it together.
Imagine a world where the government possesses alien spaceships and even bodies from beyond the stars. That's the wild claim made by David Grusch, a former intelligence officer with a serious resume. He served in the Air Force, worked for the National Geospatial Intelligence Agency, and even the National Reconnaissance Office. Now he's saying the government has been hiding a decades-long operation to recover and study crashed UFOs and their pilots.
How many crash retrieval incidents have there been?
It is double digit. The specific numbers I do know, however, I can't discuss that.
Grusch says this program involves multiple government agencies and private companies, all working together in secret. They'd be recovering both intact alien vehicles and wreckage from crashes. If this is true, it means the government has had proof of extraterrestrial life for a long time, but has kept it all under wraps.
It is a reverse engineering program to garner some kind of insight.
Think about it, intact alien spacecraft. Imagine the technology they could hold. We could learn about advanced propulsion, material science, and way more than we even know exists. Even the wreckage would be a treasure trove of information about how these crafts work. And it gets even more interesting. Grusch claims defense contractors are involved too. These companies often have the top-notch facilities and expertise needed to analyze and even try to understand how these alien technologies work. It all paints a picture of a joint effort between the military, intelligence agencies, and private companies, all working together to unlock the secrets of extraterrestrial technology. Pretty mind-blowing stuff, right? Okay, so we talked about the bombshell claims that the government might be hiding alien spaceships and even bodies from beyond the stars. But if all that technology is real, what would it mean for us mere Earthlings? Buckle up, because things are about to get even more mind-bending. Imagine spaceships that can cheat the speed of light or even bend gravity itself. That's the kind of stuff whistleblowers like David Grusch are talking about. This could completely redefine space exploration, making it possible to visit distant galaxies in a fraction of the time it takes now. The possibilities for scientific discovery and understanding the universe would be mind-boggling. But it's not just spaceships. The materials used in these crafts could be unlike anything we've ever seen, potentially stronger, lighter, and even able to withstand the inferno of a star. This could revolutionize all sorts of industries, from building lighter and safer airplanes to creating next-generation medical equipment that could withstand extreme environments. Imagine the incredible advancements in fields like transportation, construction, and even everyday consumer goods. Then there's the whole energy question. If aliens have cracked the code on unknown energy sources, like harnessing the free energy from the universe itself, it could be a game changer. We could ditch fossil fuels and switch to clean, renewable energy sources practically overnight. This would not only have a profound impact on the environment, but could also usher in a new era of global cooperation and energy independence. Now, the idea of alien weapons is a bit scary. We wouldn't want any hostile forces getting their hands on super-powered ray guns, right? But there's another side to the coin. If we had advanced defensive technology, it could actually deter potential aggressors and promote peace through superior defensive capabilities. Imagine a world where the threat of large-scale conflict is significantly reduced because no one wants to mess with a civilization wielding unimaginable technology. So, whether these claims are true or not, one thing's for sure: the potential implications are staggering. They could rewrite the course of human history in ways we can't even begin to imagine. It could usher in a new era of scientific discovery, technological advancement, and even global peace. But it's important to remember that these are just hypothetical scenarios based on unconfirmed claims. However, they do serve as a thought-provoking reminder of the vast potential that lies beyond our current understanding of the universe. We delved into the claims of whistleblowers like Bob Lazar and David Grusch, who allege the government is hiding alien spaceships and technology. Now let's zoom in on Lazar's specific story, which is filled with mind-bending ideas and controversy.
I did get a chance to look inside the craft on only one occasion. And this was important because where the reactor sat might have been critical to how it operated.
One of Lazar's central claims is gravity wave propulsion, a concept suggesting these alien spacecraft could manipulate the fabric of space and time itself for movement. Imagine them creating a bubble of warped space, allowing them to travel at phenomenal speeds, perhaps even exceeding the speed of light. Lazar went a step further, elaborating on how this propulsion system supposedly works. He introduced a special element, element 115, which he claimed was the key ingredient. According to him, this element, when stimulated with protons, could generate an incredibly strong gravitational field that could then be harnessed for propulsion. It also allegedly functioned as a limitless energy source for the entire spacecraft. Now here's where things get complicated. Scientists haven't found any evidence to support Lazar's claims. The element he described, element 115, actually exists and is now called Moscovium, but it bears no resemblance to what Lazar described. Real Moscovium is highly unstable and wouldn't be capable of the feats Lazar attributed to element 115. Adding to the skepticism, scientists have pointed out inconsistencies between Lazar's explanations and established principles of physics and materials science. Additionally, the absence of publicly available proof or demonstrable prototypes of the technology fuels further doubt. Another significant aspect of Lazar's story is the alleged government cover-up. He claims the government went to extraordinary lengths to conceal this extraterrestrial technology, from implementing stringent security clearances to supposedly harassing him after he went public. While some individuals believe him, others point to discrepancies in his background that raise questions about his credibility. So where do we stand? The truth is, we simply don't know. While Lazar's claims are undoubtedly intriguing, the lack of scientific evidence leaves them shrouded in mystery. Decades apart, two names have emerged, Bob Lazar and David Grusch, and their stories share some striking similarities that raise some mind-boggling questions. Let's rewind to the 1980s. Bob Lazar bursts onto the scene, claiming he wasn't just tinkering with gadgets in his garage. He was reverse engineering alien spacecraft at a secret facility near Area 51.
You used to work at Area 51.
Well, you know, we want to be accurate.
Okay.
Area S4.
S4, okay.
It's about 15 miles south of Area 51.
According to Lazar, these spacecraft defied the laws of physics as we know them, using anti-gravity propulsion fueled by an element unknown to science, which he called element 115. Fast forward to the present day, and we have David Grusch, a former intelligence officer with a distinguished military background, making waves with his own set of extraordinary claims. Grusch alleges that the US government, through various agencies and in collaboration with defense contractors, has been actively involved in the retrieval and analysis of crashed extraterrestrial vehicles and even biological remains. These crafts, he says, possess technology and materials far surpassing anything humanity has ever seen. If these claims were true, the implications would be nothing short of mind-blowing. It wouldn't just confirm the existence of extraterrestrial life, but also suggest that we've been secretly studying their incredibly advanced technology for decades. Imagine spaceships defying gravity, materials stronger than diamond, and who knows what other scientific breakthroughs waiting to be unlocked. Both Lazar and Grusch paint a picture of a government working tirelessly to keep this information under wraps. They describe a web of secrecy, with stringent security measures, compartmentalized information, and alleged attempts to silence anyone who dares to speak up. Their reasoning: national security concerns and the desire to maintain a technological edge over other countries. Now, it's important to acknowledge that these are extraordinary claims, and extraordinary claims require extraordinary evidence. Lazar's story, while captivating, has been met with skepticism due to the lack of verifiable evidence and inconsistencies in his background. However, he has remained a central figure in UFO enthusiast circles, inspiring countless documentaries and discussions. Grusch, on the other hand, comes with a background in intelligence and the military, which might lend his claims a different level of credibility. However, like Lazar, he faces challenges in providing concrete evidence that can be publicly verified. So what does it all mean? As of now, the truth remains shrouded in mystery. These are just stories, and until something concrete emerges, they'll likely continue to be debated and dissected by believers and skeptics alike. But one thing's for sure: they spark our imaginations and leave us pondering the vast unknown that lies beyond our planet. After all, the universe is a fascinating place, and who knows what secrets it might still hold.